Some vaccines last a lifetime. Here is why COVID-19 shots don't. During early childhood years, most of us receive vaccines against a variety of pathogens, including measles, chickenpox, and tetanus. Measles shots are good for life. Chickenpox immunizations protect for 10 to 20 years, and tetanus jabs last a decade or more. On the other hand, data shows that at least when it comes to levels of antibodies in the blood, COVID-19 vaccinations last for anywhere between 6 months and 12 months. Health officials across the globe are weighing whether to authorize COVID-19 booster vaccinations for vaccinated adults as soon as 6 months after the initial inoculation. The aim here is clear: to provide the protection afforded by natural infection, but without the risk of serious illness or death. But why then don't COVID-19 vaccinations last longer? The effectiveness of a vaccine depends on many factors, including the magnitude and the type of the immune response a vaccine induces, how fast the resulting antibody decays, whether the virus or bacteria tend to mutate, and the location of the infection. What physicians are looking for when considering the efficacy of a vaccine is the threshold of protection. This refers to the level of immunity that's sufficient to keep from getting sick. And while this parameter is known for other pathogens, it is not yet clear for COVID-19. The immune system mounts multiple layers of protection, with antibodies being just one of those layers. However, it is by far easier to track the levels of antibodies than other aspects of the immune system, and therefore, the amounts of neutralizing antibodies per milliliter of blood is the main measure of a vaccine's efficacy in the population. We must remember, however, that other aspects of the immune response, such as the formation of memory immune cells which retain the capacity of the body to respond to future infections, are also present, but much more difficult to measure in the entire population. Unfortunately, recent studies have shown that the effectiveness of certain COVID-19 vaccines is decreasing, though the vaccine shot still works well. Humanity is very fortunate with the vaccines against tetanus, diphtheria, measles, and vaccinia, for example. With these diseases, the magnitudes of response to the vaccines combined with the antibodies' rates of decay produce durable immune responses. For example, the most effective vaccines to date have used replicating viruses, which essentially elicit lifelong immunity. This is the case with measles and chickenpox vaccines, which use replicating viruses and therefore generate long-lasting immunity. Non-replicating vaccines and protein-based vaccines, such as the one for tetanus, don't last as long, but their effectiveness can be enhanced with the addition of an adjuvant, that's a substance that enhances the magnitude of the immune response. Tetanus and hepatitis A vaccines use adjuvants. Back to the world of COVID vaccines. Both the Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccines use non-replicating adenoviruses that don't contain an adjuvant. The Pfizer and Moderna messenger RNA COVID-19 vaccines, which work differently, don't contain any virus at all. In fact, these vaccines only contain the coding sequence or the instructions to tell the cell how to produce one of the virus's proteins called the spike protein. Indeed, a correspondence published in the New England Journal of Medicine by a group of researchers in the USA shows that while messenger RNA vaccines generate high antibody titers initially, their levels go down pretty quickly, whereas adenoviruses-based COVID-19 vaccines generate lower levels of antibodies initially, but they confer longer protection. Complicating things further, viruses and bacteria that mutate to escape the body's immune response are even harder to control. Measles, mumps, rubella, and chickenpox hardly mutate at all, but unfortunately, multiple variants of SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, have been found, which makes it more complicated for any vaccine, to work. The flu also mutates seasonally, and indeed, flu vaccines can only offer protection for up to 6 months, and often the vaccine has very low efficacy. Now, herd immunity is a term that relates to a condition in which a sufficiently large number of individuals in the population are either vaccinated or were already exposed to the virus, such that the number of new targets for infection are too low for the virus to effectively circulate in the population. However, the way that SARS-CoV-2 coronavirus infects the body makes that challenging. You see, herd immunity only lasts for a modest period of time, in a way that depends on how fast the virus changes, how fast the immunity wanes, and the way vaccines work. Coronaviruses replicate in both the upper and lower respiratory tracts. We have good circulation in our lungs or the lower respiratory tracts and the rest of our body, where antibodies called IgGs are secreted by immune cells, but not on the surfaces of our nostrils, where antibodies called IgA are typically secreted by immune cells. We can effectively block severe disease because there are antibodies in the lower respiratory tract, but the risk of low-level infection in the upper respiratory tract can still persist almost uninterrupted. This is why people vaccinated against COVID-19 can still be infected, but they are way more resistant to severe infection. The next generation of vaccines will likely be updated to neutralize novel variants of the virus, as well as will likely focus on enhancing immunity in the moist surfaces of the nose and lungs, also termed the mucus layers. These so-called intranasal vaccines are currently under development and in clinical trials for COVID-19. That would be all for today. Stay tuned for the next video.